Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss how to test the reliability and validity of the codes. We will use an example of researcher's dataset. In the previous video, we completed the coding using interactive coding process. An important question in coding qualitative data is how do we know our codes are valid and reliable. When we code data, we do that based on our own perspective and interpretation of the content and the topic. In other words, there may be biases in our codes. Hence, the question about the quality of the codes, invalid or unreliable codes, could lead to invalid results. There are two important points here, validity and reliability. In qualitative data coding, validity refers to the accuracy of the codes, meaning our codes reflect accurately the node hierarchy and the content. And reliability is the extent of the internal consistency of the codes, meaning the codes are consistent between coding and recording. Since we do not have the gold standards for qualitative data coding, in order to ensure the codes are valid, we need to develop a comprehensive and well-structured coding protocol, because a weak coding protocol will likely increase bias in the coding process. Minimizing bias in coding is key to achieving validity. In the next step, a common practice is to use subject matter experts with the necessary expertise to review the coding protocol and node hierarchy. These SMEs will review and comment on the node hierarchy, coding protocol, steps, and content. Based on these comments, we can revise those items to make sure biases are minimized. This is an iterative process, so it may take several iterations to get it done. In the second step, we select two external SMEs to act as coders and code the data following the same protocol. It is important to use external SMEs to ensure the data is coded correctly with minimum bias. If the codes are consistent, we have valid codes. Minor differences are usually acceptable, while major differences might raise questions about the quality of the codes. In this case, the node hierarchy and coding need further revision. To evaluate the reliability, we also use two coders, but with less strict requirements. As mentioned above, we will achieve reliable codes if the two sets of codes are consistent. The researcher can be the primary coder, and we can use an SME as the second coder. In some cases, the primary coder can perform both code and record. If the two sets of codes are similar, then we can conclude the codes are reliable. However, this approach tends to introduce bias to the codes. Hence, while it can help achieve reliability, there are still questions about validity. By using external SMEs as coders, we can minimize biases. To compare two sets of codes, we run a coding comparison query based on user profiles. Basically, NVivo links a set of codes with a specific user profile. In order to create two sets of codes, we need to connect them to two different user profiles. As I showed you before, to see and change user profile, we go to the NVivo preferences. For example, in this case, my username is truangd1 and my initial is d1. This user profile is connected to the current code as set 1. We will need to have a second user profile linked to the second set of codes. In order to do that, we have two options. First, two coders conduct the coding in two separate project files and then combine them into one project for comparison. Second, two coders do the coding and recording in the same project file. The same coder can also use this approach for coding and recording. I will show in detail how to do that in other videos. Assuming we have two sets of codes, to make this comparison, on Explore tab, select Queries and Coding Comparison. The Coding Comparison Query dialog box opens. For Coder 2, we'll select All Codes. Then, in User Group A, I select TruangD1 for set 1. In User Group B, I select TruangD2 for set 2. For calculations based on a select character for deep comparison, scenario will show better the differences between two sets. Then click Run Query. This is a comparison results with Kappa values and agreement levels. We can see the detailed comparison in the text by checking Show Coding Comparison content. The coding comparison query allows us to compare coding done by two users to measure the inter-rater reliability or degree of agreement for coding between the users. It provides two ways of measuring inter-rater reliability or the degree of agreement between the users through the calculation of the percentage agreement and Kappa coefficient. Percentage agreement is the number of units agreement divided by the total units of measure within the data item displayed as percentage. Kappa coefficient is a statistical measure which takes into account the amount of agreement that would be expected to occur through chance. A note about Kappa coefficient. Cohen's Kappa coefficient is a statistical measure of inter-rater reliability, which many researchers regard as a more useful than the percentage agreement figure, since it takes into account the amount of agreement that could be expected to occur through chance. NVivo has a page showing how Kappa is calculated. In addition, we have this information on how to interpret Kappa values. Typically, a Kappa coefficient over 0.75 indicates excellent agreement. 0.4 to 0.75 indicates fair to good agreement, and less than 0.4 indicates poor agreement. We also have references for that on this page. This is how to determine validity and reliability of the codes. In other videos, I will walk you through how to create two sets of codes and conduct coding comparison with specific examples. Thank you and bye now.